I am Mrs. Issa Rifkatulani, an assistant director, vice principal, administration, and in the Nigerian Korea Model School. I'm here to present a topic on school organization, operations, and multimedia-based school educational system. And on it, we have the table of contents. For now, let's have the topic. As I've rightly said, the topic is school organization, operations, and multimedia-based school education system. And when we talk about an organization, we are talking about a place that is structured, that has the people within, that have the facilities, that have all the things that makes an organization to become very formal in order to achieve a set goal. And on the table of contents, we have the school we have introduction, we have school organization and its characteristics, we have school operations, we have management for multimedia-based education, we have effects on teaching and learning process, and then finally we have the conclusion. And under the table of contents, just as I have said, under the introduction, in our societies today, everybody knows that the educational systems that we are running and admiring is the innovative one, who brings about the modification of behavior of the students in a desired direction. Then when we talk about school organization, what are we talking about? Because we have organizations that differ from one another. We have the school, we have the ministries, we have agencies, you can think about so many. But in this context, we are relating the discussion or the presentation on the school organization. And when we talk about a school organization, school is a formal organization, just as I've rightly said, and it is an arrangement or structure within which principal, supervisor, in bracket, will have head of department. In other places, they refer to head of department as supervisors. But in the school context, and especially in the FCT setting, we refer to our head of department, which means they have other teachers that are under them, but that are under the same stream. Maybe like the sciences, the languages, the mathematics, the art and social science, the pre-vog, etc. And all of these carry out different activity. The teacher, the students are all involved. They cooperate together in order to achieve one goal, which is educational achievement. Then, what are the characteristics of a school organization? When we talk about school organization having some characteristics is that it has some reasons and it has some features that make it to be a school setting. In the first place, we have the official sanction. And when we talk about the official sanction, we're talking about the authority, the authorization of giving this particular school the go-ahead to go on with school or academic activities. We have the UBEP, we have the Education Secretariat, and so forth. All these have come together to agree that the Nigerian Korea Model School should be established, should be carried out, and these are the modalities. One is that it is a school, being an organization, is a permanent structure, and it has permanent what? Members. Just as we have a barrack. You know, in the barrack, soldiers come, isn't it? And soldiers still live. When you go to NDA, we have students that go for training, and after some time, they do what? They graduate and they leave. The school is the same. We have the principal and all others. We have our students, and at a time, students graduate and others come in. So you see, it is a permanent body with members that persist. No permanent membership. As you go, another come in. Old members go, new people come in, like that. The school also has an assigned hierarchy. When we talk about hierarchy here, what are we talking about? Hierarchy in the sense that everybody can be everything at the same time. So it means there is a leadership structure, and that leadership structure starts from the highest even to the least. But in the first place, we have the principal as the leader of a school. And if the principal is the leader of the school, she is expected to have subordinates that work along with her to ensure that academic excellence is achieved. The principal, the vice principal administration, the vice principal academics, the subject teachers, in which in hierarchy position two, we have head of department, just as I've rightly said. And each of these have their different roles and responsibilities. We don't do the same thing, but we are all aiming at the same results. And every position in the hierarchy have defined roles. And when I say defined roles, the principal oversees all the activities of the school, from the academic to non-academic. Everything that has to do to the success of the running of a school, the principal is the overall boss. The vice principal, on the other hand, ensures the regularity of staff attendance, check their duty reports, check even their appearance, check how they carry out and conduct themselves in the school. And the objective and task of a school as a formal organization are perceived by the members and the school, by everyone in the school and community. So it means that one of the characteristics is that the objective and the task of a school is noticed by the society, is noticed by the community. So whatever that is going on, stories can go around from the teachers to the community, from the learners to the community, from the supportive staff to the community. And before you know it, they will say, something is happening in a location. So as we are saying, now we talk about school operations. That is that on the organization, a structural body with facilities and humans. Now when we talk about the school operation, what are we talking about? The principal manages the operation of the school. As I've rightly said, in the organization. You can't talk about school organization without mentioning the principal and the key people that play important role there. The principal manages school operations and resources to ensure a safe, caring, and effective learning environment, according to Alberta Education 2009. The principal effectively plans, organizes, and manages human, physical, and financial resources. You see, she manages the staff, she manages the learners, she manages the resources in terms of money and other material things that are in her position in order to take care of the school needs. The principal ensures that the school operation align with the appropriate bodies and authorities. I have said it earlier in the school organization, a school cannot be run without the authorization of the overseeing body and authority. Like I mentioned, the UBEB, the UBEC, and the Education Secretariat. The principal utilizes the principles and teaching, learning, and student development to guide management decision. In this context, we are saying that the principal also utilizes the principles of teaching and learning. Why is she here? So that students will come out and get adjusted in the society in an all-round educational development, not only read and write, but moral and otherwise. So when this take place, it helps the principal and the management to take decisions that will help the organization to move smoothly without problem. The vice principal administration, as I said before, oversees the human resources and personnel in the school. Who are the human resources? We have the staff, we have our learners. She assigns roles and responsibility accordingly to the teachers. We have some that are in charge of clubs and society, some are in charge of mentoring, some are in charge of a disciplinary committee, some are in charge of sports, and so on. She also ensures that the learning environment is kept clean. You can bear us witness that at most times when you come, we are up and doing, isn't it? You see the principal, the staff are up to check the environment to ensure that it is kept clean. In charge of students' admission records. You come to the vice principal administration, that is where you get to get the records of the student's admission and their data. Encourages the student to also keep their classroom clean. Then the vice principal academy checks the overall academic activities of the school. She ensures that subject teachers go into their classrooms and carry out their lessons as at when due. She ensures that students too copy their notes, do their home tasks, do their assignment, check on them. She also ensures that the desires, scheme of work and diaries and the curriculum is strictly adhered to. We cannot teach out of context. We have a manual that guides the teaching profession. And the head of department, they attend to their lessons too as well, and they also carry out some ad hoc activities that are assigned to them. But they supervise teachers that are under them by checking their lesson plan, by checking their lesson note, by checking the assignment, by evaluating how they carry out the teaching and learning process in the school. What are the effects of multimedia based? When we talk about multimedia, when we are talking about a new method of disseminating lesson, of delivering knowledge and impacting new knowledge to the learners. And this is with the use of computers, television sets, our cord cables, desktop, etc. They could be in graphic form, they could be in media form, depending on the situation at that particular time. But what are those things that make it to have effect and to be of value? One, it have an effect because students enjoy learning through computer-based multimedia instructions. You know, it gives them that ability, that attention. They concentrate more. They are able to also think fast. They become critical thinkers. They imagine. The moment the teacher comes in, they know, oh, we're going to learn something new. Let me sit alert and get what is there for the day. The multimedia-based learning helps students to recall the last discussion. If, for instance, last week I taught on food nutrients or whatever, and today I came in and I write maybe food groups or what, you know, they will recall immediately, oh, last week on the television, we saw a woman that brought out meat, that brought out beans, that brought out maize, like that, and they'll be able to now connect food groups. They will now know this belongs to carbohydrate, this belongs to protein, this belongs to vitamin. It also helps to maintain learning pace and interest. They learn at their pace. Because my imagination, I may be seeing school. Another student may be seeing another thing, but he will still get to the point of what he is there for. Students could also create better impact on learning process. When they get home, they are eager. Ah, we learn this, I can go into the internet and learn more of what I learned in the school. And using multimedia-based education supports students to become critical thinkers, quick learners, and problem solvers. They are able to think for themselves. They are able to also solve problems. Management for multimedia. In Nigerian Korean Model Junior School, the use of multimedia teaching and learning cannot be overemphasized. Learning is about acquiring new knowledge, sharpening skills, and that we can testify. You can see our teachers all the time when they have a class, they go in with their materials, with their equipment, in order to carry out the learning process. The modern-based instructional design provides a platform to learn better, faster, and even on self-paced. Teachers of Nigerian Korean Model School have been effectively utilizing this opportunity. A well-structured multimedia instructional content could encourage and support learning to concentrate throughout the class. When you have a well-structured multimedia-based environment, it helps and gives a very conducive environment for learning, and learning takes effect more. In conclusion, school organization, operations, management, and multimedia-based education system has a common goal. What is it? Academic excellence, innovative educational practices. So multimedia-based education increases imagination, enables participation. It is more interesting. Students perform well in examinations. Students are more attentive and perform better. Students don't talk to each other in the class because each one has to concentrate to get what he is there for. It enriches knowledge, thinking, and innovation. Students take fewer notes since they have digital copy. Unlike the conventional or traditional method where you write on one topic maybe 10 pages, 5 pages, and you see the student becoming very weak. Some will not even copy, but now with the major points on the board, they take it as a summary. Multimedia-based education forces teachers too. It also has impact on us to develop and invent new teaching aids, even for subjects usually taught by traditional methods, to enhance the attention span of students from various backgrounds. Thank you.